It was kind of empty until it was acquired in the 1970s by Fred and Marie, and they just had the building open as this bar that we're in right now for 40 years all by itself. She lived up in a corner room up in the top of the hotel here, and that was pretty much it. The dining room was closed, all the kitchen area was closed, so it was just a bar that was called the Nasty Casty Bar. When I grew up, this is what it was known by. Well, it operated until 2014 when our owner, Alan Affelt and Tina Mion, bought the property along with the Plaza Hotel on the other side of town, and he wanted to refurbish this project and bring it back to life. Well, the hotel was built in 1898, and it did help create a lot of this district known as the Railroad Avenue District. Back in the day, there wasn't a lot of car travel, so most everybody traveled by rail, so they would have the opportunity to travel the Southwest and stop at unique cities, such as Las Vegas. And back in the late 1800s, we had grown to be one of the biggest cities in the Southwest. We had electric streetcars here, which were only in three other cities. So a lot of unique history in this town. Doc Holliday had his dentist office just around the corner from us, one block away. So this gives you an idea of the importance of the district. This was Fred Harvey's first trackside hotel restaurant outside of Kansas. Well, Fred Harvey was an entrepreneurial restaurateur, and he had a very specific way of serving people consistently along the track lines.
Fred Harvey was an innovative entrepreneur. He was the first one to start chain hotels and restaurants. This was the start of the hospitality empire in America. I mean, he was well known before even Coca-Cola or anything else. A lot of even colleges studied Fred Harvey's, the way he started his business. You know, after Fred Harvey, I think Howard Johnson took over, because Fred Harvey really based his business on the railroad. Fred, and then people were driving automobiles, so Fred Harvey, he didn't get into that too much. And then Howard Johnson took over. But that chain, you know, the chain restaurants is kind of, you know, what he got started. And what's interesting about the Indian detours too, and that's where it was genius of the Fred Harvey Company. As the trains were dying out, people by the 20s were driving automobiles. They didn't want to take the train anymore. Some of the Fred Harvey hotels started closing down. But Fred Harvey's genius was that he incorporated the automobile with the railroad and started the Indian detour business. So people would come here on the train and then get into an automobile and do their tours.
Pertains to the absolute perfection in the way we feed the trains.
Perfection in the dining room, perfection in the dorm. We even want perfection in the Harvey uniform. Stout black shoes to keep a sense of humor. Please confine your underwear to camisole and rumor. Black shirt waist, cuffs neat and trim. The apron must be spotless from the collar to the hem.
The apron must be spotless and must have the proper swirl. That's the first requirement of a Harvey girl.
The Harvey girls were recruited, they were young women, I think originally from Kansas, maybe the first ones, recruited to bring some civility to the dining experience with the Fred Harvey hotels. So these were wholesome young women that came from good families and maybe had a little bit of a desire to have adventure in their lives, because there were not a lot of opportunities for women at that time. You know, I think they could be teachers, nurses, homemakers, and probably not a lot else. And so this was a chance for them to travel on the train and to work at these different establishments around the Southwest. And so they are credited for civilizing the Southwest. So the Harvey girls for the Castañeda lived right across the street in the Rollins building. And it was purchased by Fred Harvey as a dormitory for the waitresses. And the upstairs level was all the dormitory rooms. The downstairs level was retail space and or restaurant space. And there were 14 guest rooms or 14 dorm rooms upstairs and one bathroom. And I believe each room was double occupancy. So it's kind of hard to imagine, you know, that many women trying to get ready with one little bathroom?
Well, in June of 1899, Teddy Roosevelt and the Rough Riders had their first reunion after the Spanish-American War right here in the hotel. And a lot of his troops stayed at Lincoln Park, which is just over a block away from us. So this is, you know, when he chooses Las Vegas for a reunion, Las Vegas has pretty good significance. And my understanding was a lot of the Rough Riders were from around this area. So that's why they chose this to be the site of the first reunion.
If you want me to tell you a little ghost story, I could tell you a ghost story. So one of the stories I'd heard, because when Mr. Affelt was renovating this hotel, he always had a someone here on the property, like a caretaker, to stay here and oversee things. And this one fellow, nicknamed Red, that was living here, would tell me some stories. I'd come in to do a tour and he'd say, oh gosh, I had this really weird experience last night. And so he proceeded to tell me about, one of them was a sound that was coming down his hallway all the time. He thought it was a ball bouncing at night, but then he realized later, as the sound got closer to his room, that it was a cane tapping on the floor. And so he never walked out of his room to see what it was. He was a little, his dog was also afraid. His dog would sit up in bed, he said, at night too, when he'd hear the noise. I said it was probably Teddy Roosevelt, because Teddy Roosevelt was here in 1899 at his first Rough Rider reunion. So I said, maybe it's Teddy coming back, you know, to check on things. And he said, now Teddy Roosevelt didn't use a cane. I said, yeah, but he's like 160 years old now. I'm sure he's using a cane by now.
So we were featured on the TV series Ghost Adventures several years ago, and they did get some interesting readings down in the north basement, just north of where we're at. I can tell you a story about a couple that stayed here, and they called to talk to somebody about an experience they had up on the second floor. And I happened to be working with the girl that was working that night. So I put them on the phone together, and she shared a story about a lady that visited her in the little sitting room area upstairs while she was reading a book. And the two got to talking about that, and they shared similar stories of this female that's kind of still walking the property.
I mean, Las Vegas was a boom town back then when the railroad came here. We were one of the biggest cities in the whole Southwest. We were even bigger than Albuquerque and Santa Fe back in those days. We were a major stop on the railroad. And what I love about this hotel is this amazing veranda. I mean, it is huge. And when you come here to dine, it's so lovely to sit out on that veranda, and it's covered. So even if it's raining a little bit or something, no problem. And you just, you know, look at the railroad, the train comes in. We get the train Amtrak here twice a day. We don't get any freight cars, but we do get Amtrak. Also, is that interesting painting above the bar that they uncovered while they were doing renovations. So that used to be the kitchen for the Harvey lunchroom, because the folks would, back in the day, would get off the train, come in here and sit at the lunchroom. And that was a kitchen, and that's where the Harvey girls would come out with their, you know, the food for their guests.
Back in the day, the Castañeda has a huge bakery, because we used to bake goods that the train would take to other Harvey houses. So we've got one of the biggest kitchens and bakeries in any of the buildings that were made for him. My favorite part of this job is actually working with the guests, because they come here to see this property in particular, and it's real neat to be able to share a little bit of history with them and share their excitement. You know, as you grow up here, you kind of forget that this is a really cool place, and other people come in and re-energize that from you. So it's pretty fun. A lot of the trackside hotels that were built by the Fred Harvey and Santa Fe Railroad have been torn down. So I think they get a kick out of seeing an operating first version of the hotel.